Hey guys, it's Fairy Truths here, and today I'm going to be talking to you about steps when transforming. Basically, things you should and shouldn't do when transforming, because a lot of people ask me if what they're doing is going to help this process or slow it down. So let's get started. Well, first, I'm going to talk about things that will help the spell go by faster. So the very first thing is the item that you put into your spell. So say I put this ring into my spell as the item that meant the most to me, then if you wear that or are around that item all the time while you're transforming, it'll make it go by a lot faster. You'll see results a lot faster. There isn't really a spell specifically that makes it faster. You just have to do things that you think will make it go by faster. So let's say you use your dog's fur, your cat's fur, then if you're around your cat for or your dog for a lot while the spell's going on, spend a lot of time with them, it'll help the spell go by a little bit faster. But I do recommend putting in an item that you can wear. Next thing, I don't know if I've ever mentioned, but keeping fairy dust with you at all times will really help the spell go by faster. So if you have fairy dust all the time and you just, you know, have it on you, you don't have to like take it out of the container or anything, but using that will help it go by faster. Fairy pendulums. Those will definitely speed up the process remarkably fast. They're hard to get, and they're very easy to make the spell go by a lot faster. So if you do have one of those, it's super easy to make the spell go by faster. And it also benefits you as a fairy, but I can talk about that more in another video. Here are some things that you should not do while doing the spell. Now, probably the most obvious thing would be to stay away from electronics if you can. Now, this includes, but is not limited to, your phone, your computer, even your TV. I mean, you can use household appliances like the oven, the microwave. Those things don't really affect it that much. And even a TV isn't as bad if you can't stay away from it. Projectors at school are fine. I've been asked a lot of questions about smart boards, and I did some research, and those are fine because you're not at it constantly. Usually you do leave class to go to the next class, and that gives you some time to sort of breathe from it. But the best time to do the spell is on a weekend or a holiday, because you will have that time away from the electronics there. Let me just answer one more question, and a lot of people are kind of confused on how long they should spend on electronics. And I would say maximum an hour to 2 hours a day, and you can spread those out throughout the day. It doesn't have to be an hour at a time. And I would even say just an hour every 12 hours, so maybe 2 hours a day, as long as it's within 12-hour span of each hour. So yeah, the next thing, you can't have a lot of stress on you when you're doing the spell, and that's mainly because stress has an effect on everything. Stress has an effect on the way you behave and perform in your life, and it does have an effect on your body. So if you're really stressed out, maybe your immune system will be really weak and you could get sick. It's just like that. If you're really stressed out, your body's not going to be able to be going through these changes, and it's just going to kind of fail the process. You might still get side effects, but you're still gonna feel the same pretty much. Another thing that you should try to stray away from is negative people around you. Because the reason I say this is, yes, fairies give off a very positive vibe, but when you have negative people around you and you're trying to get that positive feeling of a fairy, it's really difficult because, as I said before, although auras are mainly a fairy thing, people do have certain auras. If someone's a very negative person, that might relatively reflect onto you in a way, and it might affect the spell a little bit. So if you're around people who are really negative, I mean, you really shouldn't be around those people anyway. In my opinion, it's not good to surround yourself with negativity. So try to stay away from negative people who are always complaining and not enjoying their life and just being like negative about everything and not supporting you and what you want to do and that kind of stuff. I would say stay around positive people, and that will give you best results for the spell. Now, there is no way to really know if the spell is or is not working, unless, of course, you never get any side effects. But usually, what will happen, if you perform the spell properly, you will get side effects, but with those things affecting it, it will not completely transform. So you'll get the side effects, but that's about all you'll get. you might start getting little bumps, but those will disappear the same way they appeared. I don't know. That's the only way you can know is if after a week or two you're still not a fairy. You'll have to reverse it and redo the spell so that you can actually become a
I know a
fairy.
lot of you guys were really confused on these things, what you should and shouldn't do, and I can make a whole nother video telling you more things that you should and shouldn't do, but I just wanted to give you the basic things that, from personal experience, I know helped and didn't help. So if you guys want to hear more of these things, just let me know in the comments. I can make another video about it. That's all I have to say for this video, but yeah, that's pretty much all I have to say for this video. So if you guys enjoyed, then just comment below and let me know that you want to see more. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. Bye. Of each hour. So yeah, the next thing, you can't have a lot of stress on you when you're doing the spell, and that's mainly because stress has an effect on everything. Stress has an effect on the way you behave and perform in your life, and it does have an effect on your body. So if you're really stressed out, maybe your immune system will be really weak and you could get sick. It's just like that. If you're really stressed out, your body's not going to be able to be going through these changes, and it's just going to kind of fail the process. You might still get side effects, but you're still going to feel the same pretty
Another
much.
thing that you should try to stray away from is negative people around you. Because the reason I say this is yes, fairies give off a very positive vibe, but when you have negative people around you and you're trying to get that positive feeling of a fairy, it's really difficult because, as I said before, although auras are mainly a fairy thing, people do have certain auras. If someone's a very negative person, that might relatively reflect onto you in a way, and it might affect the spell a little bit. So if you're around people who are really negative, I mean, you really shouldn't be around those people anyway. In my opinion, it's not good to surround yourself with negativity. So try to stay away from negative people who are always complaining and not enjoying their life and just being like negative about everything and not supporting you and what you want to do and that kind of stuff. I would say stay around positive people, and that will give you best results for the spell. Now, there is no way to really know if the spell is or is not working, unless, of course, you never get any side effects. But usually, what will happen if you perform the spell properly, you will get side effects, but with those things affecting it, it will not completely transform.
Hey guys, it's Fairy Truths here, and today I'm going to be talking to you about steps when transforming. Basically, things you should and shouldn't do when transforming, because a lot of people ask me if what they're doing is going to help this process or slow it down. So let's get started. Well, first, I'm going to talk about things that will help the spell go by faster. So the very first thing is the item that you put into your spell. So say I put this ring into my spell as the item that meant the most to me, then if you wear that or are around that item all the time while you're transforming, it'll make it go by a lot faster. You'll see results a lot faster. There isn't really a spell specifically that makes it faster. You just have to do things that you think will make it go by faster. So let's say you use your dog's fur, your cat's fur, then if you're around your cat for, or your dog for a lot while the spell's going on, spend a lot of time with them, it'll help. Oven, the microwave, those things don't really affect it that much. And even a TV isn't as bad if you can't stay away from it. Projectors at school are fine. I've been asked a lot of questions about smart boards, and I did some research, and those are fine because you're not at it constantly. Usually you do leave class to go to the next class, and that gives you some time to sort of breathe from it. But the best time to do this spell is on a weekend or a holiday because you will have that time away from the electronics there. And another, let me just answer one more question, and a lot of people are kind of confused on how long they should spend on electronics. And I would say maximum an hour to 2 hours a day, and you can spread those out throughout the day. It doesn't have to be an hour at a time. And I would even say just an hour every 12 hours, so maybe 2 hours a day, as long as it's within 12-hour span. The spell go by a little bit faster, but I do recommend putting in an item that you can
Next thing,
wear.
I don't know if I've ever mentioned, but keeping fairy dust with you at all times will really help the spell go by faster. So if you have fairy dust all the time
and you just, you know, have it on you. You don't have to like take it out of the container or anything, but using that will help it go by faster. Fairy pendulums. Those will definitely speed up the process remarkably fast. They're hard to get and they're very easy to make the spell go by a lot faster. So if you do have one of those, it's super easy to make the spell go by faster. And it also benefits you as a fairy, but I can talk about that more in another video. Here are some things that you should not do while doing the spell. Now, probably the most obvious thing would be to stay away from electronics if you can. Now, this includes, but is not limited to, your phone, your computer, even your TV. I mean, you can use household appliances like the